Hi everyone, my name's Adam McIntosh, and today we're going to be going through timesheet entry within Moniroo for Business Central. So just a quick overview, just to set expectations. First, we're going to be looking at how you view your existing timesheets, and then we'll actually drill into entering some time. Within that portion, we'll actually look at our time off grid as well, which is typically used to track vacation and holiday time. And throughout the process, we'll also talk about some of the configurable options that one can set when entering time. So let's go take a look. Okay, so here I am in my timesheet window within Moniroo. That's just accessed via the clock icon and timesheet entry here in your left menu pane. The view you see here is pretty much your standard view that you'll see within all the other modules. So here we're showing header information about the various timesheet documents. And then if you want to see the information within those documents, you got to click in to see the details. The mobile application as well, if you do use the mobile application, has a very similar look and feel where you have header document or header details, and then you drill into the document to view the line level details. So in this case, if I wanted to see timesheet 333, I select it and that'll load the appropriate information. In this case, it looks like it's a bunch of vacation time. To go back, I just select the back icon. So this is your traditional view. This allows you to view your historical entries by period. You can drag and drop the headings as you wish. So if you want to move something around, you can do so. You can click on the calendar icon over here if you want to select a different period, and that'll actually filter the results. So if I want to go back to my current period, it'll show my current period. I have one timesheet open for that period, which was timesheet 333. That we just saw. So I can clear the filters, I can apply filters, or I can see all the information. The filter button as well allows you to add filters based on status. So here I can see only my saved timesheets if I want, and I can see I got a bunch of saved timesheets, including that one for the current period that I'm in. If I want to hide those filters, first I should probably clear them, and then I can click the filter button just to hide that. One other option you'll see on this window is the quick entry. It's a really quick and easy way to enter time into a timesheet. What it'll do is it'll actually automatically add that time to a saved timesheet for whatever date that you're entering the time for. If you don't happen to have a timesheet for that date, it will automatically create one for you. So you'll actually see the fields in here are really the exact same as the fields in the basic timesheet window that we'll get into, and that you have a date, you select a job, here's my list of jobs, select a task, I set the number of hours in this case. You know what, I'll just type in 1 hour. And then you can have a note here. When you save that, it'll automatically update your timesheet. So you can see here the note at the top, it added 1 hour to timesheet 333. So that is just your main header window. Like I said, this is your standard display you'll see across the rest of the system. So now let's go and create a timesheet from scratch, and we'll talk about some of the details within there. So to do that, I just click the new button. If I click for current period, it's going to create a timesheet for the current period I'm in based on today's date, or I can select specific period. I can select within the calendar icon here, the date that I want to create the timesheet for, and that'll automatically create it for that period. I'm just going to click current period, click new, and it's going to create my timesheet. So it's created document 368. That's just the next document in the series here. And it's got my time off grid at the bottom, and I can start entering time here as I wish. Now, before I get into entering time, a few details. The user is obviously presented a grid here. That's your standard kind of format for entering time. And it's, you know, you select a cell within the grid based on the time and the task, and you can enter time as you wish. So in this case, I just selected on Thursday the 8th. I'm taking a sick personal day, and I can click the N key, and that'll bring up a note, and I can free text type in whatever I wish, okay? I click OK, and I can save as I wish, and quite frankly, a lot of people would save just throughout the day as they wish and as they go about entering their time. Now, you'll notice in here this starts on a Wednesday and goes, I think, for a bi-weekly period here, yep, to a Tuesday. That's completely configurable. A lot of people will go, say, a Saturday to Sunday or Sunday to Monday, and they'll just have, or Monday to Sunday, I should say. So they'll just have their week in there. Some people do bi-weekly. It's completely configurable based on your system settings, and it's really up to you of how you want to have your staff input that information. Now, this time off grid is also optional as well, so you don't even need to show that or have that available. What most people will do is they'll just have task, project and task combinations. So in here, I can select my jobs. These are all my jobs from Business Central. And these are the various tasks associated with those jobs. And I click add to add one, and then it just starts adding options to the grid. So I can put my notes in here. Okay. And I can go along, I can add further notes. This was maybe, I did more time on this date, and that'll save my note. Notes are also optional as well if your organization doesn't want to make you put in notes. But again, that's a system configuration setting that your administrator would set. So as I go about my day, I just add more and more job and task combinations. In here, you'll actually see they're filtered, or the tasks are filtered based on what's configured in Business Central. And so I just keep clicking add to add more of those options. Okay. And you'll see here I can have as many as I want, just based on and it's just based on whatever I want to enter. Okay. Now, there are a couple other features to speed up the time entry process. So you notice this little down arrow beside the add button. So I was just adding a new line previously, but I can also copy a prior week. So this is a really handy tool if you are entering or performing the same task kind of week in, week out. If I click that, it'll give me the option to copy the lines and the hours, or just copy the lines in case I want to change my hours or change what I've actually done. I'm going to cancel that real quick and show you the second option here, which is copy from a template or apply a template. So every user has a template timesheet as well that they can create, and they can assign that to this current timesheet. So I'm going to click that one. You'll actually notice it actually asks me if I want to continue to add the lines. I'll click add, and it takes a second to think, and then it adds my template time options into the grid below. So that's a really good option for those that, again, are entering very, very similar things, kind of week in, week out, or on a recurring basis. They can save their timesheet as a template and add that in. Now, the way to save the template is this little down arrow beside the save button. Click save, save as template. That'll create the template for you. Every user only has a singular template that they have access to. So let me quickly save this document. Now, just a few other really quick notes. I've been assigning my time to a job and task combination, which is the most common option that a lot of our clients will utilize. However, we can require a planning line on that job and task, so you can allocate specific resources to a job within Business Central, and that will then filter down into Moniroo as well. So that is an option. Obviously, that requires a little bit more planning up front on the job in terms of allocating those resources to the planning line. So some people will forego that because, again, it is some extra administration. There is the option I showed here earlier as well, which is your time off grid. Again, this is completely optional. Some folks won't worry about having their holiday and vacation and sick time tracked separately. So this can be enabled and disabled as well. And then within the grid itself, we can set minimum increments. So here I've just been entering round hours, but we can have anything down to two decimal places. Some clients will round their entries to every 15-minute increments. Others will leave the system wide open. It's really up to the individual company of how they enter time and what their policy around time entry is. Couple other things I wanted to highlight at the very top of the window as well. We can expand and contract this header information to show some additional fields. So in here I can see what's my billable versus my non-billable time. The non-billable obviously being those 8 hours of sick and personal time. And within Business Central as well, it denotes which these job and task combinations are billable and which are non-billable. The tasks that are set as with a budget setting of billable or budget and billable would be billable. The ones that are set for budget only are set as non-billable in the system here. I can hide or expand that clicking the button that I showed you earlier. The other thing is some folks will require attachments as well. So to add an attachment, just click the attachments button, you browse for a file, and you can upload that file. And that file will actually be maintained with this document for the life of the document as it travels throughout the system and as it gets maintained in history. So that's really it. There are other options, I should say, in terms of displaying and sorting data. So you have different views where I can see my data grouped differently. So grouped in kind of one little grid there versus separate columns. I can also group on different pieces of information as well, or hide certain days. So for example, if you don't want to see Saturday and Sunday, your weekend days, you can hide those days as well. And this is a unique view for every single user. So if I make changes in this user, it won't impact other users in the system. So at this point, I'm just going to go ahead and submit my document. So this document's been completely submitted now. Now I'm not going to take us through the approval process whatsoever. You can see here it's waiting for my supervisor to approve the document. The one thing I do want to show you though is entering time based on a start and end time. Some of our clients will enable that setting, which really changes the view of how one enters timesheet information. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to quickly stop my video. I'm going to change that system setting and I'm going to come back and show you what that data entry process looks like. Okay, so here I am. I'm back in my timesheet window. I've changed the setting now, and I'm just going to go ahead and create a new timesheet again for my current period. And then I'm going to add some lines here, and let's see how the view changes. So I'm going to select, you know, the same jobs I had before. It's going to create the same grid I had before, but now the data entry process is a little bit different. So now I'm setting start and end times. So maybe I started at, let's say 9 a.m. and my end time is, you know, 10 a.m. And this is my note. And I can save that and it'll automatically enter that hour within my grid as well. Okay. Now, if I want to go back in that same grid and add more time to that same task, I can do so. There's really no restrictions at this point. It's really based on how your organization has configured their system. So you can see here now it automatically updated that entry. And if I hover over that, it'll actually break out the lines for me with the start and end times and the notes. So just another option that some folks will have, and I wanted to show how that gets displayed in the system and how that data gets entered, because it is one of the major settings that people use and it does definitely impact the system. So I just wanted to quickly wrap up here with a quick recap. As you saw, the time was entered against a job and task combination where those job and tasks intersected with the dates at the top of the screen, determined where, you know, time gets allocated to. We do have the option to enter just straight hours like we saw in our first example, or we can enter those start and stop times as we wish. And that really does impact the user experience. Last but not least, the system is highly, highly configurable. So we can enable things like the holiday tracking grid and many, many more options, even down to the increments that users can enter time in. So we really appreciate your time today. Thanks for joining us. If you did have any other questions, please feel free to reach out to our team at info@websand.com. If you haven't already, please subscribe to our YouTube channel and please like this video as we have more great content on the way. Take care.